Hey guys, it's Nikki. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new, and welcome to my bathroom, which I hope is slightly less echoey than last time we were in here. So, the reason that you are in my bathroom today is because we're doing my skincare routine. So right now I have no makeup on. It's been a long day. I'm exhausted. It's currently probably after midnight, honestly. It's 12:29 if you're wanting the specific time. And I'm finally getting around to doing my skincare routine, which honestly, some nights I do kind of miss it because your girl falls asleep and gets too tired. But I really try to make this a priority because honestly, having my skin look the best is one of the things that makes me really confident. If you guys enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe down below. And also, thank you so much for 100 subscribers on the channel. It means a lot to me. Anyway, let's get into my skincare routine. Normally, I really don't care what my hair looks like when I throw it up for the skincare routine, but for you guys, I just want it to look a little better than usual. So first up, I'm going to take my Garnier Micellar Water. So this is the one for normal sensitive skin, and it takes off waterproof stuff. I actually don't have makeup on right now other than a tiny bit of brow gel, but I'm still gonna use it since it's normally part of my routine. So I just throw some of that on my reusable cotton round and wipe off my face. Honestly, this step tonight was a little pointless, but normally this would be how I remove my makeup. I just didn't happen to be wearing any today, partially because with COVID on the face masks, there's not much point, and partially because I just don't feel like putting in that much effort for my job. Next up, I'm going to take my Aquamarina cleanser from Lush, and this is what I use to wash my face. So first, I start with getting my face nice and wet, and then I go in with the cleanser. So to get it out, I actually use this little silicone tool. I use it for my face mask too, which you'll see later on. But really, I just use it because with these nails, it's a little hard to get product out without getting it all over my nails. Plus, this is a bit more sanitary of a way to do it. So I just take about this much product and put it on my face. I really like this product because it is really nice and cleansing and makes my face feel clean, but it's also kind of soothing and doesn't irritate my face a whole lot, so it's the perfect blend. And now I'm just gonna rinse it off. Because this is a nighttime skincare routine, I don't do this every night, but probably twice a week or so I like to do a face mask. So I'm going to include my mask in this video so you can see what I like to use, since it is honestly an important part of my skincare routine. The mask I typically like to use, I've definitely tried other ones, but this is the one I keep coming back to. It's an all-time favorite of mine. It is the Mask of Magnanimity from Lush. Yes, I struggled to say that. Normally it's not too bad. On camera, it's apparently really bad. Anyway, let's get to applying this. So I'm just gonna use my silicone applicator, which I did wash off from the face wash, and just get to applying this. Clearly, my hot glue fix didn't work too well. Seeing as my applicator's acting up, I'll just apply the rest of this with my fingers. So for this mask, I like to apply a nice thin, even layer all over my face. And I find this is really nice and just refreshing. And also, if my skin starts to act up, this is usually pretty good at getting any little starts of acne to go away. While we're waiting the 15 minutes for this to dry before I can wash it off, let's talk about the evolution of my skin. Because clearly, while my face is green, is the best time to do this because obviously it's when I look the most attractive on camera. I mean, duh. I will pop a picture on the screen right over here of what my skin used to look like. And yeah, it used to have acne all over my forehead, and it was not a good time. I got bullied a lot for it. I was really insecure, And honestly, it's not the most comfortable thing in the world, just like physically. So how did I get my face from that to what's under here? Not green. We know how I got my face green, but how did I get my face clear? Basically, taking care of my skin and using better skincare products is part of it, but most of all, honestly, it was going on birth control. Gonna keep it real, I know that's not ideal for some people, but I found it's the only thing that worked for me. I tried other prescribed things, other over-the-counter things. Honestly, nothing helped until I went on birth control. But as far as my products go, I found it's really important to keep your face nice and moisturized, but also, you know, just properly cleanse it and find a spot treatment that works so that if need be, you have something you can put on your face to sort of stop things in their tracks. So even with the birth control though, keeping my face clear can sometimes be a little bit of a challenge. So if I want my skin super clear, I have to really watch my sugar consumption, which honestly I'm not the best at, but I really should get better, both for my skin and just my overall health. Also, drinking water helps a ton with your skin. I know, cliche, but true. Something else I found though is that it's really important to keep your skin nice and moisturized. Like yes, cleansers are super important, but if you don't keep your skin moisturized, your skin's gonna produce a ton more oils and then you get acne. So really just take care of your skin. Also, I love this Kate Somerville Eradicate Spot Treatment. If I find that there's a little bit of just a hint of acne or, you know, a big old pimple, but I find it's honestly most effective when it's just the hint of them. Plus then you don't have to have it get to the big one. Is I just take a Q-tip, dip it in there, and apply it to the issue at night before I go to bed. And usually when I wake up, it's a lot better. Sometimes it's definitely not gonna work, but I find it's definitely helped me a lot. Especially when I was having more breakouts when I was younger, it was really good at stopping them in their tracks. And it still definitely works a lot for me now. I just don't tend to have as much use for it as I used to. I know it's been literally a second for you guys, but it's been about 10 or 15 minutes for me since I put the mask on, and it is hardened up. So let's go ahead and rinse it off. Mask is off. Honestly, I wish it was as effortless for me as it probably looked for you, but hey, that's life. So next up, we have toner. Now the one I've been using recently and really liking is the Lush Tea Tree Water Toner. And obviously I'm at 100 subscribers, so this video would not be sponsored by anyone, but obviously not sponsored by Lush. I just happen to love their skincare. What a pointless disclaimer. Oh well. Basically with this, I just spray it on until I feel adequately moistened. I know that's a terrible word, I'm sorry. And now we just wait for this to dry before we move on to moisturizer. Toner is dry now, so let's move on to the final step, which is the moisturizer. So for my moisturizer of choice, I use the First Aid Beauty Ultra Repair Cream. I just start by applying a bit to my face using my silicone applicator, which is clearly falling apart, and then I just blend it in with my hands. For moisturizer, it's definitely important to blend down your neck since that skin needs a lot of care too. And also you would normally want to blend basically down to here, but because I have this shirt on, it's not gonna work right now, but I assure you I will get to that later. With that, we are at the end of my skincare routine and also the end of this video. So if you made it to this point and enjoyed what you see, make sure to give the video a thumbs up and subscribe down below. I would love to have you back. And yeah, I'll see you next time. Bye guys!